The subject is reading. Reading. I don't know about you, but I read a lot. And for whatever reason, in the last week or two, there have been just, it seems like just a ton of books that have just popped up on my radar. Well, they've been published in the last week or two. And some are going to be published, you know, Tuesday's the big release date, next week, next Tuesday. I've got a stack here. And, I don't know. Let's just run through these briefly, shall we? Not a new book and not one that, I am reading for the first time, but one that I am, no pun intended, I am rereading. And it's not so much, this sounds tacky and I don't mean it this way because the content's terrific. I had the hankering to read this kind of writing. You ever do that? I mean, are there people that you follow, maybe a blog or it could be anything. It could be written or it could be, yeah, maybe even a radio show. Oh, or a podcast or you just like the way they do it. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I was craving, for whatever reason, a few nights ago, I'm sitting here and I'm just craving just that kind of blunt, bold, wham, bam, there it is stuff. And I'm looking around and I see, you know, I see the spine, I see that, and I'm like, yeah, I'm going to reread that. Haven't started this one yet, but it looked interesting to me. And I bought this one. I mostly do Kindle stuff now, but somebody gave me a Barnes & Noble gift card. And so I didn't buy an electronic version. I bought real versions. And I thought, well, this is a book that I'd probably, you know, because of the format of it, I'd probably rather have in a physical book. So that one's in the stack as well. Business Model U, a one-page method for reinventing your career. It's a lot more than one page. I haven't read it, but dreaming of a new career or life path? Well, I don't know. Maybe. I'm intrigued with business models. There's another book that's kind of like this about, it's a book of, you know, business models or that kind of stuff. And then there's a series of books, you know, about that are like visualization books. Those are better in this kind of a format. So I don't know. I haven't started that one yet. The same time that I bought that one, I bought this one. Which I would have bought, again, I would have bought, this one I would have purchased as a Kindle, but, you know, the gift card and all that. I like this guy's stuff, Clayton Christensen. How will you measure your life? And this seems like my kind of a book. On the back it says, this book doesn't offer easy answers. Well, what worthwhile book would? Instead, it will prompt you to consider the most important questions you'll ever face. Namely, how will you measure your life? I have some ideas about that, by the way. I don't know if I'll agree or disagree with him, but we'll find out. I bought this one, and if you bought it, and if you bought it when I bought it, then we likely bought it for the same reason. And we likely bought it as a hard copy for the same reason. The Michael Hyatt book. Platform. Get Noticed in a Noisy World. Mr. Hyatt, clever promotion, but, you know, come on. Who's going to beat him in clever promotions for book publishing? I mean, come on. He is the chairman of Thomas Nelson. His deal was, if you purchase the book the week that it came out, as he was trying to drive the sales up to get better rankings, buy any version of the book, he basically would give you all of the electronic versions free. He would give you the MP3, the audiobook, free. And then he had some other bonus material and stuff, a series of videos and things. Well, and those are great. I guess, I don't know yet. But I'm thinking, okay, so I can get the Kindle version and I can get the audiobook version. Well, he wasn't giving away the hard copy version. He'd give you all the others. Now, you could buy any version you wanted, and he would make good on it. And I thought, buy the hard version. Buy the hard copy version. And I have begun to read this. I'm halfway. I'm about halfway done. Good book. Good book. I've got no complaints. I'm not halfway done. I'm that far done. There's my. I'm up to chapter 19, page 73. No, it's perfectly fine book. I'm not, you know, I haven't written a bunch of notes or anything necessarily. So I'm looking at this stack, and I got some others on the floor down here. Now, let's see. Let's see what I've got. You'll some of these you may or may not appreciate. Here's another one. I reread books quite frequently, and I'm rereading this one as well. Get my hands out of the way. I'm not Vanna White. I don't know quite how to do this. That job's probably harder than it looks, you know? You think? I don't know. The 100-mile walk, a father and son on a quest to find the essence of leadership. I liked this book. I enjoyed this book. And it probably because, well, here they are. Here's the father and son. Can you see that? See if I can get this up close without completely losing focus. So you got a father and a son. I can kind of relate. No, I can relate. I'm a father and I have a son. So there's that. So there's five books that I'm reading. Two of them I'm rereading. Now I have out of camera view, I have a stack about that tall and I have another stack about that tall. Terrible, terrible, terrible habit, and I'm trying to break it. Reading too many things at one time. No, I'm not reading all of those, but there's about three, four of them I am. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there's about 9 or 10 books. And what I'll do is I'll read one, and I may read one for a day or two and not read anything else, but there are some days that I may read a little bit of one, a little bit of... And it is why you often find me chasing down the banks of my memory, trying to figure out, where did I read that? I know I read that somewhere. Well, that's why. So here's the thought. I don't know how you read. I'm curious. I'd be curious how you read. But that's how I have read forever. It could be argued that it works for me, but I'm finding not so much. And I'm finding this true, namely, because now that I see there's quite a few books coming out, and naturally I have book envy. I want these books. And it dawned on me this afternoon, why? You've got too many that you're reading now. Get these done. And I thought to myself, would it be smart of me, would it be wise of me to make a commitment that I won't buy a book, a new book, until I finished the books that are in the queue? So if I have 4 or 5 unread books, before I buy a new book, why shouldn't I read the 4 or 5 unread books? Now, admittedly, promotions come down the pike, like this one, okay, an exception. The Stephen Pressfield book, perfect example. The War of Art, the sequel. The title escapes me. Okay, it's out. Yeah, I want it. I want to read it. But I'm like, there's no special promotion going on. There's no real compelling reason for me to buy it now as opposed to buying it 2 weeks from now, a month from now. Why not knock out these books before I buy that book or any other book? I'm going to try that. I don't know that that'll work, but I'm going to try that. I'm going to try to have the resolve to make good on that. I was talking with my wife earlier this afternoon, and she's a big fiction reader. She wouldn't touch a business book for all the tea in China. My problem with fiction is obsession. And that can be good or can be bad. I can fall into some fiction books, and I don't juggle fiction like I juggle these. I will, if I get a novel and I like it, I'm in. I mean, I'm in. And I'm in until I finish. And I'll spend every spare moment reading it. And so this sounds terrible because I love them, but I stay away from them because these, I can read a chapter or two here or there and I can put it down. But if I get engrossed in a story, well, it's the power of story. Isn't that the power of story? Sure it is. So if I get engrossed in a novel, I can't stop. I have to keep reading, you know, so I'll stay up. Well, I stay up late at night anyway, but, you know, I'll keep vampire hours to finish a novel if it's a good novel. The other thing that I can put a business book down if I'm reading or any that are in kind of, these aren't all business books, but kind of sort of. I can read one of these and I can get in and I can think, yeah, you know, this isn't doing too much for me. And I'll hang with it. Admittedly, I'll hang with it too long. I've talked about that in the past. But I can put it down and forget it. I have a hard time doing that with a novel. You just keep thinking, hang with it. You know, just hang with it because I do have some questions. I am kind of curious about this character. I'm kind of curious about this situation. You know, the story's not all that compelling. And I'll find myself diving in way too many hours into a bad book. Or at least one that I think is bad. And then I'm just utterly disgusted because you know what I'll do. Yeah, I'll finish it. Yeah, devote another day and another day and another day. And then 4 days later you finish and you're like, you know, 4 days ago I should have burned the stupid thing, but I didn't. You know, I hung with it and thinking it would turn around. And I don't know. Do you have similar experiences? So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to find a good novel. Well, you know, how do you find a good novel? Yeah, you follow the crowd. You go with the herd, and the herd often lets me down. So I'm gonna try to read, you know, one or two fiction books a month. I can't do more than that because I'll get too engrossed. And I'm not going to buy any new book until the books that I have right now in hand are read. We'll see if I can keep up with that. My name is Randy Cantrell. The website is BulaNetwork.com. And I'm surrounded by books and some music and some cartoons and some other cool stuff in a place that you know I call the Yellow Studio.